Made Visual brings together photography, fashion, and installation art, all curated to shed light on South Africans who have historically been denied their rights.
In 1994, the enactment of the South African Constitution guaranteed the rights of women, of rural people, of LGBTQAI plus people, and yet not all of those rights have been realized. And so these artists are examining the problems in South African society and how they can be fixed through awareness.
Catherine Waisaki Gunch is the Teal Curator for African and Oceanic Art at the MFA. She discovered a collector of South African beadwork here in Boston. And from that, the inspiration for this exhibit was born.
And what I was most inspired by with the Endebele beadwork is the fact that women in mid-century were using their clothing and their style of house painting to protest the South African government's refusal to see them as their own culture. I thought it would be interesting to see what South African artists had to say about that and see how it spoke to American audiences.
Christine McLaughlin and her husband Bob were making their way through the museum when they were drawn to this exhibit.
It's very moving to see the use of color, fabric, to capture such a violent part of their history so beautifully.
This photograph, titled A Terrible Beauty Is Born, boldly showcases the color purple, a shade with a rich and deep history.
In the 1980s, during the anti-apartheid protests in South Africa, protesters were sprayed with purple dye so that they could easily be arrested the next day.
Another piece features five dresses made from a cloth often worn by rural women, marking them as lesser in the eyes of some South Africans. Performance artist Senzeni Marisela's work repurposes the garments into a rallying cry.
She wants to make present in an urban space where these women are often ignored or seen as invisible. They're still waiting for a chance.
As they continue to wait, the curator hopes these people and their messages will be made visible to a new audience.
As we consider our American society and its failures and successes, this is a good moment to think about people who have been institutionally excluded and to maybe learn from the South African experience and from these artists who are proposing a new way forward.